All right, welcome back. You can hit us up on Twitter at the FF Dynasty. Join the discussion. You can tell us that we're dumb or that we're really smart. Either one is okay with me. You can hit me up personally at IMC Myers. Big Co's at Dynasty Big Co. Jay Wayne's at Jay Wayne's World. Let's dive back into this thing. We're going to go to Detroit here, the Motor City. Marvin Jones has finally jumped his counterpart in Golden Tate in the ADP here. Which one spectacular year here from Jones, and he's great. Are you buying into that? Do you like Jones ahead of Tate? First and foremost, I'll start with that question. Do you like Jones ahead of Tate?
That's a toughie.
That is a toughie because Tate
toughie
has,
but goody. I think Tate could be out of there.
We got two different kind of receivers here. You know, you got a guy who's 90 catches a year in Tate
and consistent in doing it.
Right,
and there's a lot of value in that consistency.
And Marvin is more of like a kind of a bigger play kind of receiver, right?
Yeah, no doubt. Yes, yards per catch is out of this world, and he's just like a 4 for 80 and a touch kind of guy, 7 for 100, 2 touchdowns kind of guy, 6 for 100 and a touch. I mean, he puts up the big plays when he's putting them up. I'm just pulled up his game log, and
yeah,
man, when it's right, and. For the last couple of years straight, I mean, the Lions have led the league, been up there in the tops of the league for attempts, and they haven't been
able to aren't running the ball.
No, exactly. Well, they haven't been able to get this running game right. They keep saying they're going to pound the rock, and I keep telling you every offseason, I've told you that for 2 years in a row, that does not, don't believe them. Don't believe them. They're still going to air it out. And the best thing they have going is Matt Stafford, and they put some talent around him. And right now we're talking about Marvin Jones versus Golden Tate, but they got Galladay and Ebron. They got mouths to feed. I just Golden Tate just makes a living with the yak and the making just moving the chains.
He's kind of safe. He's got 92 catches for just over 1,000 yards, and Jones has got 61 catches for 1,100 yards. So it's just you're seeing two different types of ways to score fantasy points out of these two.
Jones had more touchdowns and Tate had more catches. So in the PPR leagues, they're pretty much about the same. Jones probably outscored him a few points with the extra couple touchdowns there. But
so Jones is a year and a half younger than Tate, and he's also on contract for more years. Like, this is Tate's last year on contract with the Lions. They got Marvin through 2020. So he'll be a free agent in 21, according to the contract.
Right.
So I don't know if that weighs into the whole Jones versus Tate
has
question.
To weigh in a little bit. But another thing, too, though, about Tate, like, dude doesn't get hurt. And Marvin Jones was his first. Like, I was beating the drum for Marvin Jones last year. I was telling all you guys, like, listen, those first 2-3 games in the season last year, Jones was leading the league in yards. Stafford was just dropping the ball in on the very edge of the sidelines, and Jones was toe-tapping and falling out for a 48-yard gain. That's what he was doing. He had a 200-yard receiving game in the beginning of the year last year and just was tearing it up.
He was a deep threat.
Then
he got banged up.
Big play guy, and he got banged up. And the same type of injuries that he had when he was in Cincinnati, which is why he didn't get a contract extension from the Bengals. And so now that Marvin Jones did it for a year and he's up here in the 54, and I saw him just get traded. Somebody gave him away for a first-round pick in a 2019 first. I don't know that I can buy into Marvin Jones at 54. I was the one buying him at 100 last year. I would love to, but his injury history, I just don't know. I worry about that ankle or whatever it is, Jay Wayne. It's that foot. That thing scares me. Tate, I know Tate's a little bit older. And I don't know if I'm buying Tate at 58 either, because I got him on almost all my teams, and he's been killing it with those 90 catches every year. But he's getting a little long in the tooth now, so I'm really not sure. If I had to make a decision, I probably would take Marvin Jones because he's younger and he's explosive. But that foot worries me, and I know Golden Tate's going to lace him up for me every week.
Yeah, I think I'm okay with Marvin Jones being ahead of Golden Tate. I like what he's doing. I like the way he's being used. I think, again, he's a little younger. He'll be with Stafford for a little while longer. So I'm okay with him being ahead of Tate. I love the safety of Tate. I'm okay with always putting Golden Tate on my team. If you're going to sit around and disrespect him, I got no problem with putting those catches on my team. He could go somewhere else for sure. They got Galladay kind of waiting in the wings here, and Ebron, they just picked up his fifth year, so that's kind of interesting. How do you feel about it before we get into any further discussion here? You Tate or Marvin Jones?
I guess I would go Jones over Tate as well. But I'm kind of like Big Co here, and I feel like 54 and 58 I'm looking for somewhere else. Can I get up to 51 and get Will Fuller instead? Really, that's
sure.
That's kind of where I'm at. And then,
I
and
like
then
that.
You got to take somebody here, though. So, you know, I don't know.
All right. Well, before we add one more guy to the mix here, let's. Kenny Galladay's coming in. His ADP's at 79 here. Mm-hmm. So he's already getting a ton of love. And he's maybe kind of similar to what Marvin Jones does for this team.
Yep.
And he comes in and you're expecting him to take a big step forward this year. Like, does that impact your decision on either one of these two guys to maybe, I mean, something's probably got to give here for, you know, they throw it to the backs a good bit. Ebron's coming back. He's been up and down. He had a decent middle of the season and maybe end of the season. I don't have the numbers in front of me here, but you know, there's volume. Is going to become a volume issue if there's this many mouths to feed. And is who do you think would be the odd man out? I don't think it's Tate.
Right.
I don't, not this year.
Right.
But I don't think you're drafting Galladay at 79 for necessarily for this year.
Yeah.
You're looking down the road. You're looking dynasty. And I don't think Galladay's presence there does anything for my opinion of Tate. I'd probably be trying to sell Marvin Jones right now. Like, not to get off of
that's what we're here
Galladay,
to do right now.
But I think I'm trying to sell Marvin Jones, and I think because Tate's maybe not as line dependent. Marvin, well, that doesn't make sense either. I don't know. Marvin could go somewhere else. He does have a lot of money they owe him. They could probably get out from that with guarantees. So he's not. It's not like he's gonna be there for the next 3 years. If they got Galladay coming up, he's gonna be cheap for the next 3 years. Marvin could be expendable. They could bring Tate back. Who knows what's going to happen with any of these dudes? I like Galladay's talent level, but at 79, that seems a little steep.
So if their three receiver sets are Marvin, Galladay, and Tate in the slot, like
sounds like to me, Matt Stafford's about to be a deal.
Right.
If you tell that this is good, and like you said, I mean, Ebron,
and I love Galladay. Ebron, I was telling y'all boys that don't draft any receivers and get Galladay late.
That was your line, and you said it before anybody. I'll always give you credit for that. Casey was on Galladay super early.
But 79
last
year. Does seem a little high, and I think something's got to give here. So what is it?
Well,
it's
Ebron,
the running game. The running game is going to give up
carries
all their anything.
The Ebron came on super strong towards the end of the year. I think you were right on. I think you're on the right track there, Jay Wayne. With Golden Tate's not lion dependent. Golden Tate is out there. He's going to get open and he's tough to tackle. And those are traits that travel.
Right.
But you saw right away, in 2016, first game of the season, there was a magic between Jones and Stafford. And if Jones would have stayed healthy, this would have happened last 2016.
It started to happen last year.
That's what I'm saying. It happened for a couple games and then he got nicked up. And so I think that Marvin Jones needs Stafford more than Golden Tate needs Stafford. Galladay did nothing to disappoint in a rookie season. He was just showed some tremendous flashes.
And he's fantastic down the field.
I think going forward, I'm taking out of this that Stafford's going to be underappreciated coming into the season. He's coming. He's doing the
getting
old quote,
head coach change,
quote
here.
Unquote mental prime coming in, just like I said about old Matt Ryan
years ago.
Stop
wearing his hat backwards.
Right.
You know Colin Cowherd hates the backwards hat guy.
He can't be a quarterback.
Stafford's got his hat on straight.
You can't have your hat on backwards if you're a quarterback in the NFL. That is what Colin Cowherd says. It's hilarious. I think the moral of the story here is
it's cool.
like a backwards hat.
Yeah, but no grown man on the sideline of a football field should be wearing a backwards hat. Put it forward.
They're playing freaking a game.
I'm just kidding.
They're playing a game. Let him wear his hat.
I
started wearing my hat backwards lately because it makes me look younger. my wife goes, "What are you talking about?" And I looked her dead in the face, and I had my hat on backwards, and I turned it around forward. I said, "See, look,
that's older." 5 years at least.
I said, "Older," and I turned it back around backwards. I said, "Younger, older, younger." And she said,
"Mature, immature."
She said, "Yeah." And then when you put that visor on, you just look like a douchebag.
Oh, so. Visor, totally different game.
Out of here!
Totally.
And if you have a backwards visor. Immediate slap in the face.
Oh, left hand open hand slap.
All right, let's get back to business here.
I think Golden Tate has earned the right to be here at 58, but at 29, if you look at this list here, he's old in the tooth to be up. He's got Dez Bryant a couple picks in front of him, and the young guys have taken over the dynasty ADP in the top 100. I mean, we were talking about that before.
Galladay's proof. He's at 79. I mean, not to say that he had an okay year last year, but I mean, he really hasn't done a ton to prove out and to be like, I'm going to take him at 79.
Right, to be top 80 ADP. I mean, but the Lions are stacked on offense, and if they could do something with the scheme over there to open up, get a little bit of a running game going, I think the Lions.
If they could just get Deion Lewis.
My Lions are about to blow up.
Yeah.